Hello guys, Aloy Andalus here, and a lot of people ask me how to do this effect in Storm, this elastic figure that deforms, and it's quite easy. So here with Storm, you can grab a demo version and try to replicate that in your own. That's a fresh new scene. I will go to add object, granular system. We need a granular system, and let's add a source. This will create granular particles, but we want to change the source. So let's change geo. Then I have a dense alembic deformation. You can grab it from Mixamo or whatever. Let's open. You can also press F. F, you will focus to whatever your object is. So if you're a scene, you don't know where they are, you press F, you will where it is. And right now I can see that it's too big. So let's scale this down. On source, we have read scale. The read scale will reduce the scale of this by 10. That's because it's imported. Normally you need to scale it by 10, depending of the application you are getting this from. It's also interesting to check always the draw voxel grid to see if it's big enough. Right now, maybe it's too small. We want something kind of fast and doesn't need to be too accurate. So you can go to SDF voxel grid, go to 0.2, make it bigger, and then you can say draw voxel grid again to false. Another thing is, let's press space. There is no animation going on. That's go to global settings. Normally we start at 1000, from 1000 to 100, 300. Let's change it. The time range is from 0 to 300. And I saw that the particles are too small. So for this test, I will decrease the quality. Resolution go to 5. We can always increase it later. And in global parameters, I will as well max substeps keep it at 8, so it will go faster. And let's press space again. And you can see that we have something going on already. We have these particles, it's creating particles and it's smashing and breaking. So how to fix the breaking stuff? Because right now it's breaking maybe too much. In global particle systems, you will see that we have constraint break strange. This will say after this stretch, break. So if you put a big number like 3, now it will take much more stretch to break. So you will see that it's not breaking and it's creating some cool stuff. But another thing that is happening is that, for example, it's emitting too much. I want to emit in more steps. So in our source, you can see that you have rate multiplier. Rate multiplier is how often do you want to create particles. So if we go to 0.1 and let's press reset, you will see that it will emit way less. And it's up to you to adjust these values. Maybe 0.1 is not so many. So I will go to 0.2. So we will create a little more. Other cool stuff that you can see here is that we have a speed inheritance, velocity inheritance. So if I go to 4, when it's creating particles, you can see that it's inheriting the velocity of each part of the geometry. So even if it's deforming, it will grab the velocity of the arm or the head or the legs. So now we are multiplying by 4 the velocity, so the particles will go way faster. Let's restart from 0. The first frame, there is no velocity, so it falls down, but after it smashes and it can create cool stuff. Other stuff that we can do. If I decrease velocity inheritance again to 1, we can play with some of the parameters. You can see that it stretches quite a lot. To avoid that, if you don't want so much stretching, go to particle stiffness. You can increase this to 300 and 300, and you will have less stretchy particles. You will see that here it will be more rigid. If you want even more rigid stuff, you can increase the constraint max length. By default, it's 3. So it's the constraint max length is how far each particle looks for parents to create a join. and it's multiplied by the radius. So if you go to 5, you will see that it will create much more radius. It's as well a little slower, and it's wider because it means that it creates more constraints, but it will try to create something much more solid. So everything will not deform so much. If you want even to create it more solid, something that you need to have is more subdivisions. So you can, we can try to go to 1818 and then constraints stiffness. Let's try to crank this up to 600. Now you can see it tries to stay much more on the original position. It depends on the look that you are looking for, but it's interesting to know that you have all these values available in a storm to create different types of deformations. That's kind of fun. Let's go to 8.8. Let's reduce this by default, constriction max strength to 3. And keep it like that. Now it's exploding because we had the constriction stiffness is too big for the substeps that we have. So what I would like to show you is what happens if we do the opposite. We decrease this. You will see that now they will stretch much more. It's a much more elastic material. And let's try to go even less. Mostly it's the constraint stiffness that will make a big difference. And doing that, we will need to have the break strength. Let's try it like that. See how it stretch, and now it breaks because obviously it stretch way more, but you have all this cool stuff. Again, now if you don't want this to break never, go again to the constraint break strength, increase it to 9, so you will be sure that it will be always impossible. Even if they go too far, it will not break. And you can create this kind of weird stuff that can be quite fun as well. So that's all. That's how I create this effect. I hope that you like it, and you have a lot of things to play with in a storm to create snow or these kind of elastic effects. Other things that we didn't show is the slashiness and the plasticity. It's kind of self-explanatory. Plasticity, the particles will deform and keep this new deformation. And yeah, have fun with it, guys. Thank you and see you soon. Bye.